So here I am at our ASTM walk-in climate control chamber, which is at the centre of our testing facility. I'd like to hand you over to Angela Southey, who's going to take you through some of the specifications of this chamber.
I'm Angela Southey and I'm head of the environmental test chambers here at Airmid Healthgroup. Yeah, in this room here we have two environmental test chambers. There's a large one here and the slightly smaller one to my right. And then down the corridor we have two other additional chambers which we also use for bedding testing. And then in the microbiology lab we have smaller scale chambers which we can use for small scale studies. An environmental test chamber such as this is a 28.5 metre cubed chamber, and it has a double skin on it and is completely sealed so that we can control the temperature and humidity inside in the chamber, the number of air changes, and we can monitor the particles in the air in real time using our particle counters. And we can also measure allergen and on the surface and airborne allergen and surface and airborne microbes. In this type of chamber, we can assess anything that's found in the domestic environment, including electrical appliances such as vacuum cleaners and air cleaners, and flooring, wall coverings, and textiles. Well, Airmid Healthgroup specialises in measuring airborne particulates, and these can cover quite a wide range of things, include allergen, ultrafine particles such as viruses, bacteria, mould, and other airborne pollutants. When the samples come out from the chamber, they are processed in a number of our laboratories, including the allergen laboratory, where we sample for allergen from surface samples and airborne samples. And then we also bring samples to the microbiology lab from this chamber, and we can test for viruses, bacteria, and fungal spores on surfaces and also from the air as well. Yes, in addition to this window here where you can observe everything going on in the chamber, we also have an anteroom here which is positive pressure, and this prevents cross-contamination between what's going on in the chamber and outside in the environment. There's a number of sample points in the chamber, so we can take air samples, we can monitor the particle counts in the room, and we can also measure airborne allergen and airborne microorganisms through these sample ports. And then the chamber is also controlled by a computer system, which we will see in a few moments, which can control the temperature and humidity of the chamber, but it can also do real-time monitoring of data coming from the chamber. Now, just at the other side of the chamber, where there's two additional sample ports, which we use for air sampling. So these two sample pumps are used for measuring allergen. It traps them onto glass fibre filters, so we can use that for airborne allergen. This pump here is used for sampling liquids, so it captures viruses that are airborne, and it captures them in a table into a chamber inside in the room. And then this sample pump is for capturing microorganisms such as bacteria and viruses and fungi onto petri plates. Yeah, in addition to real-time monitoring and capture of data which goes on here at the chamber, this chamber is in the centre of our facility, which enables us to distribute samples to the different laboratories for microbial analysis for bacteria, fungi and viruses, and also for allergen analysis in our other lab. Yeah, the air supply comes in from outside, but it's HEPA filtered as it comes in. So this is absolutely sterile. There'll be nothing below 0.3 microns able to, or above 0.3 microns able to pass through. So it's effectively sterile air comes into the chamber. And then once the air is taken out, it's also HEPA filtered out through to the exhaust, which is out on the roof. And then inside the chamber, there's a heating coil which will heat the air coming in, so you can control your temperature within plus or minus 2 degrees. And then there's also a humidifier built into the chamber as well, which will control the humidity to within plus or minus 3% relative humidity. Well, you can contact me directly at the details shown on the screen here, or you can go to the website where there's further information available and you can contact us through the website.